وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، we were in the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we were speaking about Allah tabarak wa ta'ala protecting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We mentioned in our previous lesson that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he never drank khamar and he never got close to drinking it, and nor did he come anywhere close to committing zina, alayhi salatu wa salam. Allah protected him from all of that. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم معروفا بالأمانة. And our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was well known to be a trustworthy person, عليه الصلاة والسلام. He had محل ثقة. He had a place in the heart of the people. They trusted him. They believed in him, عليه الصلاة والسلام. They would not give their products or their stuff except to him, alayhi salatu wasalam. And if they did give it to him, he would give it back to them as the way that they gave it to him. No one would tell him, alayhi salatu wasalam, a secret. Or they won't tell him a speech. إِلَّا وَجَدَهُ عِنْدَ حُسْنِ ظَنٍّ بِهِ. Except that the person would find that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he would come out to be the one who would keep that secret for them. And he wouldn't tell anyone about it. This is how he was, alayhi salatu wasalam. وَلِذَلِكَ before Islam, amongst Quraysh, he was very well known as Al-Amin, the trustworthy one. They gave him that name. They used to say Al-Amin, the trustworthy one. As though there was no one else who was trustworthy except him. The Prophet ﷺ, he would also be a person who told the truth. The things that he said, he was a truthful person, alayhi salatu wasalam. And truthfulness, it was from what? It was from min sifatihi al-bariza. It was from the apparent characteristics of his, alayhi salatu wasalam. Shahida lahu bidhalika al-adu was-siddiq. The friend, the close one, and the enemies all testified to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam's truthfulness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam to all of mankind. And he commanded him sallallahu alayhi wasalam to warn his family members. He went out and he called them. And he started to call Butun Quraysh, all of the tribes of Quraysh. And when they all came together, he said to them, أَرَأَيْتُكُمْ لَوْ أَخْبَرْتُكُمْ أَنَّ خَيْلًا بِالْوَادِي تُرِيدُ أَنْ تُغَيِّرَ عَلَيْكُمْ أَكُنْتُمْ مُصَدِّقِيًّا. The Prophet said, if I was to inform you that there is horsemen that are behind this valley, and they are coming to destroy you and to change your affairs, أَكُنْتُمْ مُصَدِّقِيًّا, would you all trust me in this statement of mine? Do you believe when I say this to you? قَالُوا نَعَمْ, they said yes. مَا جَرَّبْنَا عَلَيْكَ كَذِبًا قَطْ, they said نَعَمْ, yes, we've never known you to lie, عَلَيْهِ صَلَاةُ وَسَلَامُ. And this was after the ayah came down, وَأَنْذِرْ عَشِيرَتَكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ, warn your closest family members. So they are saying, مَا جَرَّبْنَا عَلَيْكَ كَذِبًا قَطْ, we have never known you to be a person who lies, عَلَيْهِ صَلَاةُ وَسَلَامُ. وَلَمَّا قَالَ هِرِقْلَ هِرِقْلَ وَلَمَّا قَالَ هِرِقْلُ, when the leader of the Romans, who was the king of the Romans, he said to Abu Sufyan ibn Harbin, he said to him, and at this time Abu Sufyan was a mushrik, He said to him, أَكُنْتُمْ تَتَّهِمُونَهُ بِالْكَذِبِ قَبْلَ أَنْ يُقَالَ مَا قَالَ أَمَا قَبْلَ أَنْ يَقُولَ مَا قَالَ Did you suspect Nabi Muhammad of بِالْكَذِبِ lying قَبْلَ أَنْ يَقُولَ مَا قَالَ Before he said what he said, which is to say that he's a prophet from Allah. Before he claimed that he's a messenger sent from Allah and he's a prophet from Allah, did you ever suspect him of lying? قَالَ لَا He said, no. Hiraqla then said, فَقَدْ عَرَفْتُ أَنَّهُ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيَدَعَ الْكَذِبَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكْذِبَ عَلَى اللَّهِ Hiraqla said, I have now come to know that he will not leave off lying about the people. He wouldn't leave off lying about the matters related to the people and then go and lie about Allah. He can't do that. The person, before he lies about Allah, he first of all has to lie about the dunya affairs. He has to make up lies. And then after that, he may move on to what? Lying about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if Nabi Muhammad wasn't lying to them about the normal stories that they have, and it was truthful, alayhi salatu wasalam, he would not be one who would lie about Allah by saying, I'm a prophet, Allah is telling me this. And spend the next 23 years of his life saying things that he's never said for the first 40 years of his life. He wouldn't be one who would do that. Alayhi salatu wasalam. One of the things that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam had, he was a wusulan lirrahimi. He was one who kept the ties of kinship. Atufan ala al-fuqara'i. He was one who was very kind and soft and generous towards the poor and the ones in need. وَذَوِي الْحَاجَةِ وَيُقْرِئُ الضَّيْفَ He was dutiful and good towards the guests. وَيُعِينُ الضَّعِيفَ He will help the weak one. وَيَمْسَحُ بِيَدَيْهِ بُؤْسَ الْبَائِسِينَ And he would wipe his hands on the palm and the pain that any Muslim would feel on his body parts. If they needed them to be cured, he would run his hands by on them, alayhi salatu wasalam. Leaders don't touch people. Kings don't touch people. You can't touch the queen. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam was what? يَمْسَحُ بِيَدَيْهِ بُؤْسَ الْبَائِسِينَ وَيُعِينُ الضَّعِيفِ He would stand up and help the poor. Salawatu Allahi wasalamu alayhi. A woman would take the Prophet ﷺ and she'll take him through all of the city of Medina alayhi salatu wasalam, and she would get from him everything that she wanted. She would use his reputation, his name, to get what she wanted. And he would sallallahu alayhi wasalam go with her wherever she wanted. وَيُفَرِّجُ كَرْبَ الْمَكْرُوبِينَ If anybody came to him and told him they are suffering from something and they're in need, he would sallallahu alayhi wasalam intercede on that person's behalf to uplift the distress on them. And he would say, مَنْ نَفَسَ عَمْ مُؤْمِنٍ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ الدُّنْيَا نَفَسَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَاللَّهُ فِي عَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ مَا كَانَ الْعَبْدُ فِي عَوْنِ أَخِيهِ Anyone who releases from a brother a stress of his and a pain that he's suffering from, anyone who comes and brings joy to a brother who is stressful, you make him smile, you make him happy. You say to him, what's stressing you out? Debts. It's all paid. What else? If you do that, a believer, you take that away from him. مَنْ نَفَسَ عَمْ مُؤْمِنٍ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ الدُّنْيَا Worldly issues. What will happen to you? نَفَّسَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ Allah will remove from you the stresses from the Day of Judgment. الْجَزَاءُ مِنْ جِنْسِ الْعَمَلِ You will be rewarded with something greater. That Allah will remove from you the hardship and the pain of the Day of Judgment. So the Prophet was one who set an example in that regard. وَقَدْ وَصَفَتْهُ بِهَذَا أُمِّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ خَدِيجَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ عَنْهَا And the Prophet's wife, Khadija, testified to that matter. And the wife is the one who knows her husband the most. Khadija testified to this particular matter فِي بَدْءِ الْوَحِي In the beginning of the revelation. فَقَالَتْ She said to him, when he came back, shocked about what he just encountered and what he saw. He just met Jibreel. He's never seen this before. So what did she say to him? كَلَّا وَاللَّهِ No. By Allah, لا يخزيك الله أبدا. Allah is not going to humiliate you. Allah is not going to forsake you, Nabi Allah Muhammad. Allah is not. إنك لتصل الرحمة وتحمل الكلة وتكسب المعدومة وتقرئ الضيف وتعين على على نوائب الحق. She said to him, you keep the ties of kinship. You, this is your characteristics. Allah will not forsake you. Look how she used the way that a person deals with the people as to be the way Allah is going to deal with you. So what did he say to her? What did she say to him? She said, Allah will not forsake you because you haven't forsaken the people. You haven't forsaken the community. You haven't forsaken the rights around you. إِنَّكَ لَتَصِرُ الرَّحِمَةِ You keep the ties of kinship. You're aware of what your family are upon and their affairs and their issues. وَتَحْمِلُ الْكَلَّةِ And you also, you take the burden. You take the burden of the people. By doing what? By al-infaqu, by giving to the one who's in need, by helping the orphans and the children and other than them. وَتُكْسِبُ الْمَعْدُومَ وَتُقْرِئُ الضَّيْفَ وَتُعِينُ عَلَىٰ نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ And you are one who comes with the rights of the what? You come with the rights of the guests, etc. These are characteristics that were mubarraz of him, alayhi salatu wasalam, that he was known for. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, before he became a prophet and before he became a messenger, he had what? كَانَتْ أَمْثَلُ حَيَاتٍ وَأَكْرَمَهَا He had the best of lives. He was the most generous, he was the most noble, he was an example prior to Islam, he was an example, alayhi salatu wasalam. He came with what a person could look up to, a role model, he was alayhi salatu wasalam. And when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made him into this, he then became what? A prophet, sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this, my beloved brothers and sisters, teaches us that to be somebody who is pious, somebody who is good, even before you started to actually practice, but you are a good person, is better than trying to come across as though you were the devilish, the worst person. Some people, they fantasize about this idea that subhanAllah, I was in jahiliyyah. I was upon dhulm and udwan. I was upon fisq and fasad. And now Allah has guided me. So they like this narrative. And so they push it a lot. It's actually not something honorable. It's not good to say that I had bad. In Nabiullah Muhammad, Allah chose him as a prophet to be because his nobility before Islam was great. He had great characters, karama, very generous person, azamatun nafs. Allah made his soul, alayhi salatu wasalam, great. And then Allah made him a prophet and a messenger. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, As Ibn Ishaq says in his seerah, فَشَبَّ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وَاللَّهُ تَعَالَى يَكْلَأُهُ وَيَحْفَظُهُ The Prophet ﷺ reached the age of 40 and Allah was protecting him. Allah was taking care of him. وَيَحُوطُهُ مِنْ أَقْدَارِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ And Allah was removing from him, getting, protecting him from the what? مِنْ أَقْدَارِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ The pre-Islamic doings. لِمَا يُرِيدُ بِهِ مِنْ كَرَامَتِهِ وَرِسَالَتِهِ Because Allah wanted to honor him. Allah wanted to also what? Allah wanted to place the message onto him. حَتَّى بَلَغَ أَنْ كَانَ رَجُلًا Until it reached that he became a man. وَأَفْضَلَ قَوْمِهِ مُرُوَةً And he became the one who had the best morality in his people. وَأَحْسَنُهُمْ خُلُقًا The best of characters. وَأَكْرَمُهُمْ حَسَبًا And the best of lineage. وَأَحْسَنُهُمْ جِوَارًا And he was the best one to reside next to, the best neighbor. وَأَعْظَمُهُمْ حِلْمًا And he had the best forbearance. عَلَيْهِ صَلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ وَأَصْدَقُهُمْ حَدِيثًا And he was the most truthful one. وَأَعْظَمُهُمْ أَمَانَةً And he was the most trustworthy one. وَأَبْعَدُهُمْ مِنَ الْفُحْشِ وَالْأَخْلَاقِ الَّتِي تُدَنِّسُ الرِّجَالَ And he was the furthest from what? Al-fuhsh, evil doings. وَالْأَخْلَاق And etiquettes and characters. التي تدنس الرجال that will taunt a man's reputation. تنزها تكرما حتى مسمه until he is what? حتى مسمه في قومه إلا الأمين. To the extent that he had known other name amongst these people except الأمين. لما جمع الله فيه من الأمور الصالحة. Because Allah gathered in him matters which were honorable. Great. القاضي عياض. He said, وكان صلى الله عليه وسلم That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was what? Majbulan alayha. That good character was something Allah naturally built in him. في أصل خلقته وأول فطرته. It was placed in his natural disposition. This is his essence and what he was made from. لم تحصل له باكتساب ولا رياضة. This did not come to him from what? That he had to exercise and he had to work hard on himself. No. إلا بجود إلهي وخصوصية ربانية. He gained this by Allah's generosity, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah specified him with this. الإمام الذهبي he said in his Sirah على من نبلاء والذي لا ريب فيه, that which there's no doubt in. أن المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet, كان معصوما قبل الوحي. He was infallible before he became a prophet. وقبل التشريع من الزنا قطعا. And after he became a prophet, he was far from zina and sexual misconduct. ومن الخيانة والكذب. And he was the furthest from what? Deception and lying. والسكري and being intoxicated. والسجود لوثن and to prostrate to an idol. والاستسقام بالأزلام and to use the throwing of lots. Which they used to do. ومن الرذائل and the low, immoral things. He was far from it. والسفه وبدائل اللسان, dim-wittedness, and having a tongue that's just long. وكشف العورة, his exposure of his عورة. He never had all of that. فلم يكن يطوف عريانا. The Prophet never went around the Kaaba naked. ولا كان يقف يوم عرفة مع قومه بمزدلفة. And he never, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he never used to stand with his people. ولا كان يقف مع عرفة مع قومه بمزدلفة. The day of Muzdalifah, he wouldn't stand with these people. He would stand separately, alayhi salatu wasalam. بل كان يقف بعرفة. Muzdalifah, he wouldn't go. He wouldn't stand with these people in Muzdalifah. But when it was Arafah, he would. He would stand there. وبكل حال لو بدا منه شيء من ذلك لما كان عليه تبعة لأنه كان لا يعرف ولكن رتبة الكمال تأبى وقوع ذلك منه. And if he did all of that, and that all happened from him, he wouldn't also be blamed for it because he didn't know it. But rutbatul kamali, to be complete, refuses that you've done all of that. Even if he did all of that before he became a prophet, we would have said that's before Islam. What's the problem? Sah? But he didn't. Because to be complete, it means you didn't do that ever. Even when you didn't know it. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was an ummi, he never used to read, nor could he write, alayhi salatu wasalam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never did it ever come to him to be what? To become a prophet. It never came to his mind. لَمْ يَحْلُمْ بِذَلِكَ فِي يَوْمٍ مِّنَ الْأَيَّامِ. As Allah said in the Quran, وَكَذَلِكَ أُوحِيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. The Prophet never ever thought of becoming a prophet. And he would never be able to write. Allah gave that to him. He said, وَمَا كُنْتَ تَرْجُو. You never ever hoped. أَنْ يُلْقَى إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابُ. You never hoped that a Qur'an will be sent onto you. إِلَّا رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ. That was only done based on Allah's mercy unto you. فَلَا تَكُونَنَّ ظَهِيرًا لِلْمُجْرِمِينَ. فَلَا تَكُونَنَّ ظَهِيرًا لِلْكَافِرِينَ. Don't be one who is a supporter and an aider of the disbelievers. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as I said, was not one who could read nor write. And this was a hikmah, a wisdom of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was ummiyan, la yaqra wa la yaktub. He could not read nor write. فَكَانَ أَبْعَدْ عَنْ تُهْمَةِ الْأَعْدَى. Because this made him the furthest from the suspicions of the enemies of Islam. They would think evil of him. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't make him one who could read, nor could he write. Allah said in the Quran, وَمَا كُنْتَ تَتْلُو مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَلَا تَخُطُّهُ بِيَمِينِكَ إِذَا لَرْتَابَ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. Allah says, وَمَا كُنْتَ تَتْلُو. You are not one, Muhammad, that could write. مِنْ قَبْلِهِ, before it. مِنْ كِتَابٍ, you couldn't write a book. Could write anything. وَلَا تَخُطُّ بِيَمِينِكَ, and your right hand couldn't stitch these information together. You couldn't. إِذَا لَرْتَابَ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. And if you were one who could read and write, if you were one who could do that, لَرْتَابَ الْمُبْطِلُونَ, the disbelievers would start to suspect and say, maybe he wrote this himself. They would say that. Some people say that the Prophet ﷺ, he could always write. Who said he can't write? That's an insult for the Prophet ﷺ. That's a what? It's an insult for the Prophet ﷺ. It's an insult for him. What we say is that it's not. Rather, for him is kamal. That he came out with this knowledge and he couldn't write. It's praiseworthy for him ﷺ. Just like arrogance is a praise for Allah, not for you. Arrogance is a what? It's a great characteristic of Allah. But for a human being, it's not. You have not got the right to be arrogant. So they say this ayah is not an evidence to show that the Prophet couldn't write, because Allah says, وَلَا تَخُطُّوا بِيَمِينِكَ. You couldn't write with your right. You couldn't write with your right. So maybe he was a left-handed. We say this is خَرَجَ مَخْرَجَ الْغَالِبِ. The majority of the people, they write with their right. And when Allah negated it, it means the majority. It doesn't necessarily mean the right hand. Okay? خَرَجَ مَخْرَجَ الْغَالِبِ. And Allah even called him in the Quran, Ummi. Allah called him it. Allah says, الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّيَّ الَّذِي يَجِدُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِنْدَهُمْ فِي التَّوْرَاةِ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ. So Allah referred to him as what? الْأُمِّي. لَا يَكْتُبْ وَلَا يَقْرَى. And with all of that, what did he come with? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came out with this Quran. We're now going to go into irhasat. Al-ba'tha. We're going to speak about al-irhasat. Muqaddimat. Tell signs that took place before the Prophet was sent as a messenger. Things that happened. The first of them is حَجْبُ الشَّيَاطِينِ عَلِ اسْتِرَاقِ السَّمْعِ عِنْدَ قُرْبِ مَبْعَثِهِ. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, there's a story Ibn Ishaq mentions. فَلَمَّا تَقَارَبَ أَمْرُ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. Ibn Ishaq mentions that when the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, his time came close, that he was going to become a prophet, it came close. وَحَضَرَ مَبْعَثُهُ. And him becoming a prophet was very close. حُجِبَتِ الشَّيَاطِينُ عَلِ السَّمْعِ. The angels, they were veiled from hearing. They were what? Sorry, the shayateen, the devils, were veiled from hearing. وَحِيلَ بَيْنَهَا وَبَيْنَ الْمَقَاعِدِ. Between them and the hearing that they used to sometimes hear, there was placed between it a veil. I mean, in other words, they got blocked from the hearing. They couldn't hear anymore. فَرُومُوا. They got thrown at them بِالنُّجُومِ. Stars, shooting stars, were thrown at them. The jinns before, they used to climb each other. And they would go to the top. And they would listen. They would what? They would listen. And anything that's been told to the angels, and the commands that are being given, they would steal. That's why they are called, as Allah mentioned in the ayah, istiraq al-sam'a. Istiraq comes from the root word, tastariq al-sam'a. Ay yasriq al-sam'a. He steals the hearing. It's when a person eavesdrops and takes information that's not meant for him. He steals that information. He steals it with his ears. By hearing it, they were like that. That's what they would do. The jinns, when they went up on each other, this time, it got closed off from them. So when they saw this take place, shooting stars were thrown at them, and then the guards were multiplied. And they were also being thrown at them, shooting stars. They recognized something is not normal. Something has changed. Walidhalika, fortune tellers, they speak to the jinn. And the jinns, they climb up each other, and they get some information like that. And they bring it back. Allah tells us in the Quran, He says, قُلْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ أَنَّهُ اسْتَمَعَ نَفَرٌ مِّنَ الْجِنِّ فَقَالُوا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا قُرْآنًا عَجَبًا يَهْدِي إِلَى الرُّشْدِ فَآمَنَّا بِهِ وَلَن نُشْرِكَ بِرَبِّنَا أَحَدًا
وأنه تعالى جد ربنا ما اتخذ صاحبة ولا ولدا وأنه كان يقول سفيهنا على الله شططا وأنا ظننا أن لن تقول الإنس والجن على الله كذبا وأنه كان رجال من الإنس يعوذون برجال من الجن فزادوهم رهقا
Until Allah تبارك وتعالى He said
وأنا كنا نقعد منها مقاعد للسمع فمن يستمع الآن يجد له شهابا رصدا وأنا لا ندري أشر أريد بمن في الأرض أم أراد بهم ربهم رشدا
سورة الجن Those ten, first ten ayats that came down. In these ayat, Allah تبارك وتعالى, what does he tell us? That the jinns, they heard and they recognized something was not normal. Let's mention the long hadith in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim, in hadith Ibn Abbas. Ibn Abbas said, مَا قَرَأَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ The Prophet did not read. عَلَى الْجِنِّ The Prophet didn't go and read on the jinn. He didn't. وَمَا رَآهُمْ And they didn't see him. The jinns, the Prophet didn't. Sorry, the Prophet didn't see the jinns. The Prophet didn't go and read to the jinns. Nor did the Prophet see the jinns. He said, انطلق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في طائفة من أصحابه. The Prophet went out with some of his companions. عامدين أي قاصدين, intending إلى سوق عقاضة. The Prophet went with some of his companions and he went to سوق عقاضة. وقد حيل بين الشياطين وبين خبر السماء. And the shayateen, the news pertaining to the sama, what they used to take, it got blocked off from them. وَأُرْسِلَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الشُّهُبُ Flaming stars, shooting stars were thrown at them. فَرَجَعَتِ الشَّيَاطِينُ إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِمْ The shayateen came back to their people. فَقَالُوا They said, مَا لَكُمْ Their people said to them, what is it, what's up? قَالُوا They said, حِيلَ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَ خَبَرِ السَّمَاءِ The sama and the news that we take from it has become blocked from us. وَأُرْسِلَتْ عَلَيْنَا الشُّهُبُ And shooting stars have been thrown at us. قَالُوا مَا حَالَ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ خَبَرِ السَّمَاءِ What is it that has made you become blocked from the what? From the news of the sama. What is it that blocked you off from it? وَبَيْنَ خَبَرِ السَّمَاءِ إِلَّا شَيْءٌ حَدَثَ Except something took place. The only thing that's stopping us from not hearing what Allah is saying to the angels and what's taking place between the angels and we can't steal anything, is that something has taken place on this earth. فَاضْرِبُ مَشَارِقَ الْأَرْضِ وَمَغَارِبِهَا Go to the east and the west, and see the earth, what is taking place, and what is happening. فَانْظُرُوا مَا هَذَا الَّذِي حَالَ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ خَبَرِ السَّمَاءِ And go and try to find out, get to the bottom of what is it that's trying to get between you and the news of knowing what's happening in the sama. فَانْطَلَقَ الَّذِينَ تَوَجَّهُوا نَحْوَ تِهَامَةٍ Some of them went towards the angle of Tihama. إِلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ بِنَخْلَةٍ عَامِدٍ إِلَىٰ سُوقِ عُقَاضَ So they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam next to a tree in سُوقُ عُقَاضَ وَهُوَ يُصَلِّ بِأَصْحَابِهِ صَلَاةَ الْفَجْرِ And the Prophet was leading his companions. He was leading them صَلَاةُ الْفَجْرِ So they sat down, they listened. فَلَمَّا سَمِعُوا الْقُرْآنَ When they heard the Quran, استمعوا له وقالوا they said, هذا والله الذي حال بينكم وبين خبر السماء. This is what has got between you all and the information of the سماء. This is why you couldn't hear what was taking place. فهنالك حين رجعوا إلى قومهم فقالوا they said إن then they went back to their people. They went back to their people and they said to their people إن سمعنا قرآنا عجبا. We heard a fascinating Quran speech. يهدي إلى الرشد فأمنا به and it guides towards that which is correct فأمنا به what could we do? We believed in it the jinns are saying this فأنزل الله على نبيه قل أوحي إلي أنه استمع then Allah تبارك وتعالى he sent down سورة الجن on the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام الإمام الترمذي he narrated and Ahmad in his Musnad with a sanad which is sahih, a chain which is authentic, a chain that is authentic على شرط الشيخين upon the conditions of Bukhari and Muslim. And Ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما, that he said, كان الجن يستمعون الوحي, that the jinn used to listen to the revelation. فيستمعون الكلمة فيزيدون فيها عشرا. And they would take a speech and they would add 10 onto it. فيكون ما سمعوا حقا. So what they would hear would be the truth. وما زادوه باطلا. And what they would add onto it would be باطل. So when they listen to what's happening in the sky and the angel what is saying to each other, they would take one word but they would add things onto it. What would they do? They would add 10 onto it. And each one would add something onto it. وكانت النجوم لا يرمى بها قبل ذلك. And before that, the stars will not be thrown at them. فلما بعث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, when the Prophet was sent, كان أحدهم لا يأتي مقعده إلا رمي بشهاب يحرق ما أصاب. But then when the Prophet got sent down as a messenger, as a prophet, the shooting stars started. فشكوا ذلك إلى إبليس. So they went to Iblis and they complained to him. فقال إبليس, said to them, ما هذا إلا من أمر قد حدث. This has only come because of an issue that has taken place. فبث جنوده. Then Iblis went out and he sent his army. فإذا هم بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يصلي بين جبلي نخلة. The Prophet was there next to a tree and he was praying عليه الصلاة والسلام. فأتوه, they came to him. فأخبروه, they came to Iblis and they told him what they saw. And then he said to them, Iblis, هذا الحدث الذي حدث في الأرض. This is now what has taken place on this earth. Here there's a point that needs to be pondered over, which is Ibn Abbas's narration here, it kind of negates that there were shooting stars before the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And if we look at the narration that Al-Imam al-Suhayli rahimahullah brings from Abdul Razak ibn Hammam al-San'ani in his tafsir an Ma'mar ibn Shihab al-Zuhri, that Ibn Shihab al-Zuhri, when he was asked about al-Rami bin Nujumi, the shooting stars, akana fil jahiliyyah, before Islam, prior to Islam, were there shooting stars? He said, na'am. Ibn Shihab al-Zuhri said, yes, there were shooting stars. ولكنه, but, إذا جاء الإسلام, when Islam came, غُلِّضَ وَشُدِّدَ. When Islam came, the matter became very tough. It just, reinforcement took place. The angels, the protecting of the sama became more. Okay, more people were protecting the sama. And more protection was given to the guarding of the sama was, it was multiplied. Oh, there was always a guard. And also what? And also, the shooting stars were extra enforcement that was put to him. Why? What's the evidence for that? Because Allah said in the Quran, He said, وَأَنَّا لَمَسْنَا السَّمَاءَ فَوَجَدْنَاهَا مُلِئَتْ حَرَسًا شَدِيدًا وَشُهُبًا. So the ayah tells us that فَوَجَدْنَاهَا, we found the sky, the angels, the jinns are saying this, مُلِئَتْ, it was filled with guards, شَدِيدًا وَشُهُبًا, and stars. So before that, there were shooting stars, but they were not muliat, it wasn't filled with it. The word muliat gives us the understanding of what? That the guards were there. But now what's happened is that it's muliat means what? When something is filled. Naam. ولذلك حافظ الحجر رحمه الله, he mentions that this is what? After the statement of Abdul Razak, which he brings from Ma'mar ibn Rashid and Muhammad ibn Shihab al-Zuhri, Ibn Hajar says in Fath al-Bari, وَهَذَا جَمْعٌ حَسَنٌ. The way that Shihab al-Zuhri brings it together is good. Which is that the narrations, the one that negates it happening, it means it is negating in terms of its frequency. And the one that's affirming it, it's affirming it due to its quantity and how large it is. Okay? Here's the question, inshaAllah ta'ala, which is, after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent as a messenger, did the shooting stars stop, or do they still carry on? Did they carry on after Nabiullah Muhammad was sent out as a prophet? Did the shooting stars carry on? And what's the discussion of the ulama in that regard? We'll leave that for next lesson, inshallah ta'ala, bi'idhnillah al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.